I wonder.
I wonder why.
I wonder why.
I wonder.
I wonder.
I wonder.
Science is wondering.
You're going to place a sticky note on there and put some questions that you guys are like, ooh, yeah, we all have the same question, right?
I think phenomena are definitely important for student learning so that they can experience and make sense of learning and the world in a way that generates that curiosity.
So that was a phenomena for Elton back in the Quad Cities a long time ago. Why are the bald eagle populations not producing new offspring?
I think it makes them curious, which is really what the goal of science should be, is getting students to be curious and wanting to learn about how to solve problems in regards to the natural world.
Using your data yesterday, you're going to write down things that you notice from your data and then things that you wonder at this point about your data.
A notice and wonder activity is when the students are provided a prompt and then they are given the opportunity to write things that they're noticing about whatever it is that's offered to them, and then also what they're wondering. These seem very similar, but it actually allows the students to feel comfortable with naming things that are in front of them, and which might not always be what the teacher would expect them to notice, but then also gives them an opportunity to share about something that they've always wondered about that, or that maybe they didn't have the opportunity to ask about before. So I teach eighth graders, and when I think about relating our science content to the real world, there's a lot of pros and sometimes there's some cons. They come into class with a lot of what we call misconceptions, and that happens naturally because we all live in the natural world, and when we don't have somebody explaining everything to us all the time as we walk around in our day, we ended up trying to explain things to ourselves, which happens at a very young age, where students are like, I wonder why the sky is blue, and then they start to make up things for themselves unless somebody is teaching them. So we name those misconceptions sometimes with the eighth graders, and then we will relate to them and explain, you know, the accurate ideas or help them get to those accurate ideas. So the pro then is that they have all this experience and they're able to make connections with science content versus what they have been outside with or where they've experienced something along the way. Phenomena is important to student learning because the students can relate to it, and they also see a real life meaning for learning what they're learning, to understand that these concepts that they're learning about aren't just some random thing that is in a book somewhere or is talked about by scientists, which seem kind of an elusive thing to them. It brings it in their backyard, brings that to their community, and they realize that science is all around them, and how they can explain events around them is by science. A helpful part of setting students up for success when using noticing and wondering in class would be modeling asking questions yourself as the teacher. That also goes for driving question board. If they're allowed to ask questions, if they're allowed to what sometimes feels like go on a tangent during class, if they know that that's allowable and accepted by the teacher, then they're going to be more willing to ask those questions that they're wondering about.
It's probably important to wonder about the world because, like, you gotta understand how things come to be. You can't just, oh, that's how that got there. But you have to kind of understand it and then comprehend it and then, like, use it. So you can't just, like, get the answer and know. You just kind of have to work at it and, like, I would say comprehend and grab the material and say, oh, that's how it came or something like that.
Destroys other plants that are used as food sources and, like,
I think, curiosity and just like questions need to be encouraged. So if a younger kid asks you, oh, how does this work or why does this happen, you just need to explain it to them in terms that they can understand. Just encourage that behavior because the younger generation is what's going to grow up and help solve these problems that we can't.
Hi, my name is Jacob.
it's just like the way the picture was taken.
I think it is really important to wonder about the world around us just because, like I said, everybody is different and there are so many different aspects to life. And just to have those questions in the back of your head really keeps you going and makes you want to like learn about different things.
What do you wonder about?